हेलो दोस्तों, मैं हूं स्मिता कुमार और आप देख रहे हैं आपका अपना हेल्थ चैनल मेडी सर्कल। आजकल हम अक्सर हाइपरटेंशन के बारे में सुनते हैं। ऐसा इसलिए है क्योंकि हाइपरटेंशन हमारी सोसाइटी में काफ़ी प्रेवलेंट होता जा रहा है। सीनियर वृद्धों में और सीनियर सिटीजन्स में देखी जाने वाली ये बीमारी आजकल यूथ यानी यंग जनरेशन में भी काफ़ी देखी जा रही है। आंकड़ों के हिसाब से करीब 33% अर्बन और 25% रूरल इंडियंस हाइपरटेंशन से ग्रसित है, जिसमें से 25% रूरल और 42% अर्बन पॉपुलेशन को ही पता है कि वे हाइपरटेंशन से ग्रसित हैं। यानी ऐसे बहुत सारे लोग हैं जिन्हें ये पता ही नहीं कि उन्हें हाइपरटेंशन है। इनमें से करीब सिर्फ 1/4 पॉपुलेशन का ही ट्रीटमेंट चल रहा है। एक और स्टडी में जहाँ 15 से 49 ईयर्स की आयु के करीब 7,31,864 यानी 7,31,864 लोगों का सर्वे किया गया, उसमें यह देखा गया कि करीब 18.1% लोगों में ही हाइपरटेंशन है, जिसमें से करीब 76.1% ने कभी अपना बीपी मेजर किया था और केवल 44.7% को उनके डायग्नोसिस के बारे में पता था। इनमें से करीब 13.3% ही लोग ऐसे हैं जिनको ट्रीट किया गया है और कुछ 7.9% लोग ऐसे हैं जिन्होंने इस कंडीशन पर कंट्रोल पा लिया है। हाइपरटेंशन को डिटेक्ट करना और भी जरूरी हो जाता है क्योंकि हाइपरटेंशन के कोई सिम्टम्स नहीं होते हैं और साथ ही साथ चूंकि इसका कोई क्योर भी नहीं है, इसे आप सिर्फ दवाइयों यानी मेडिसिन के जरिए और साथ ही साथ लाइफस्टाइल मॉडिफिकेशंस यानी जीवन जीने के जो तरीके हैं उसमें बदलाव ला करके आप उस पर कंट्रोल पा सकते हैं, उसे कंट्रोल में रख सकते हैं। हाइपरटेंशन बहुत बार जानलेवा भी हो सकता है क्योंकि ये कई सारे हार्ट प्रॉब्लम्स यानी दिल की बीमारियों का भी कारण होता है। इस तरह से हमें हाइपरटेंशन के बारे में जानना और भी ज़रूरी हो जाता है। आजकल की स्ट्रेसफुल लाइफ में हाइपरटेंशन बहुत ही कॉमन हो गया है यंग जनरेशन में, तो वो क्या चीज़ें हैं जिनके बारे में हमें ख्याल रखना चाहिए, वो क्या चीज़ें हैं जो हमारे लिए अलार्मिंग होनी चाहिए जो हमें ये बताए कि शायद हम हाइपरटेंसिव हो रहे हैं, और अगर हम हाइपरटेंसिव हैं तो किस तरह से हमें उस पर कंट्रोल करना चाहिए, डॉक्टर की सलाह कब लेनी चाहिए और साथ ही साथ कब अपने बीपी को मेजर करना चाहिए, कंट्रोल करना चाहिए ताकि हम एक हेल्दी लाइफस्टाइल जी सकें। मेडी सर्कल आपके पास लाता है राइट इन्फॉर्मेशन सीधे डॉक्टर्स, एक्सपीरियंस डॉक्टर्स और एक्सपर्ट्स की जुबानी। तो आइए डॉक्टर्स से ही जानते हैं कि हाइपरटेंशन क्या है, उससे जुड़ी हुई प्रॉब्लम्स क्या है और किस तरह से हम हाइपरटेंशन पे कंट्रोल पा सकते हैं। स्टे हेल्दी, स्टे ट्यून टू मेडी सर्कल।
Hypertension is a condition in which blood pressure in the arteries is persistently elevated. High BP is also a major risk for heart stroke, heart diseases. Lifestyle changes and medications can lower the blood pressure and risk of health conditions. At MediCircle, we are presenting World Hypertension Day Awareness Series, wherein we are featuring eminent cardiologists to create awareness amongst general population about their preventive action. Hi, this is Sana Khan, and today in this initiative, we're going to speak to Dr. Vanita Arora. As the first female electrophysiologist of India, Dr. Vanita is a pioneer female cardiac electrophysiologist in the country. She has earned awards like Rising Star in Cardiology, Women Doctor Entrepreneur of the Year 2018, Chikitsa Ratan, along with several other outstanding achievements in her medical career spanning more than 2 decades, and is currently the director and head of cardiac electrophysiology lab and arrhythmia services at Max Healthcare Super Speciality Hospital in Delhi. She has been a distinguished faculty member in several national and reputed international meetings such as HRS and APHRS. Also, she is the elected secretary of IHRS. Hello, Dr. Vanita. Welcome to MediCircle. How are you?
Thank you, Sana. I'm good. Thank you for having me on the show.
It is a pleasure, ma'am. Okay, Dr. Vanita, what causes high BP?
So you're starting from the basics. What is the cause of high BP? Yeah. If you will ask any layperson, they will say all the stress around us is the cause of our high BP.
True.
But in talking in medical terms, I would say, see, there are 2 types of high BP conditions. One is primary and another is secondary. Okay. So when you have... As you are aging, your arteries become thickened. the arteries, the blood supplying, the source which supplies the blood to the whole body, that is an artery, that becomes thickened from inside.
Okay.
So the lumen becomes smaller, okay, because they are getting thickened, right? They're becoming more thick. So when the lumen becomes smaller, the place to for the blood to pass is, it is restricted.
Correct.
It is restricted, yeah, narrowed down. So once it is restricted, this resistance is blood pressure.
Okay.
How easy? So if I have to explain it in very layman's term, you know the plumbing action. You have the plumbing fittings in your house for the water pipes, right? The water pipes have been laid down. So if the pipe is small, the water will go with a lot of force.
Correct.
Yeah. So that's blood pressure.
How well explained.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is what happens with age. You know, once people start aging, their arteries become thickened, and that's why they have blood pressure. Now, the other causes are basically which are reversible, which can be reversed, which can be prevented. And they are in form of hypertension in young people.
Okay.
Many times you see a 25-year-old male or a 28-year-old male, he has blood pressure. So there can be other things which are responsible for that, apart from a family history of hypertension. There can be something known as pheochromocytoma. That means there is a tumor on top of the kidneys, which causes this. And it is a reversible cause. If you take care of that tumor, the blood pressure reverses back to normal. Then the artery which supplies the blood to the kidneys, the renal arteries, in case they are narrowed down, that can also cause hypertension. That can cause high blood pressure. You open up those arteries and the hypertension is solved. So we need to understand.
Is reversible, right?
Yes, absolutely. You don't need any medication. You just open that artery up, you put in, you do the angioplasty of that artery, put in a stent there, and your blood pressure becomes normal.
Okay.
So this is how blood pressure is there. That is why when you have blood pressure, it is a good idea to see a cardiologist to get yourself analyzed whether you have any kind of a reversible cause for hypertension, or if you do not have a reversible cause, then of course you have to take medical therapy and control your blood pressure, of course.
So, Dr. Vanita, what type of diet is helpful in controlling BP? Is there any particular diet that you would suggest?
Correct. Yeah, of course, that's a very good question. For blood pressure, diet is important. Apart from diet, we'll discuss more things, what are more important to control blood pressure, not only diet. So you have to have a balanced diet. You know, eat a lot of, eat greens,
okay.
Eat vegetables, eat healthy food. You know, that is very important. But most importantly, the salt intake, that matters. Now, once a person comes to know that he or she is hypertensive, they give up the salt totally. That is wrong. You don't have to give up the salt totally. You have to take a low salt diet, not a no salt diet.
Okay.
It is not no, N-O-N-O. It is low, L-O-W, low. Mm. So what you have to do is you have to avoid extra salt. The food that we make in the house, ghar mein jo khana banta hai, hum sab ke liye banta hai, right? So we take that food, we eat that food, but we do not add salt from above. Like if you're taking curd, if you're taking salads, if you're taking fruits, don't add salt. Don't use table salt to add. Achar, papad, chutney.
No.
That is a total no-no. It has too much of a salt.
Correct.
In achar, we use salt as a preservative. If you have seen your parents or your mother making achar, you know, she will use loads and loads of salt as a preservative in the achar. So it's a lot of salts. The namkeen that we eat, you know, the bhujia and all that we eat, it has a lot of salt as a preservative. So this is all extra salt. Right. The bakery products have soda. You add soda if you make cakes and bakery products and cookies and all. No? So they all have salt in them. Mm-hmm. So you have to avoid these. These foods have to be avoided. Rest, you can eat all the foods, and you make a special effort on having salads, on having these fruits and natural ingredients, have dal, have you know, healthy food. That's what I'm trying to
say. The balanced diet that we were always suggested since we were in school. A perfect balanced correct. Diet. Right.
Correct. So if you are overweight, you need to lose weight. Mm-hmm. If you are, do not have a sedentary lifestyle, please take a walk. If you cannot run, if you cannot, go to the gym, then at least take a walk.
Right.
Walk as much as possible. Stop taking lift, climb up the stairs. So these are the things that you have to do. I know we are in the corona time, so we cannot do all these things. We can't go to the park and walk. There are a lot of limitations and restrictions. But yeah, of course, we will come back to normal. Our normal lifestyle will come back and then we can do that. But if you are overweight, you should lose weight.
Okay. So
that's very important.
Okay, doctor, what are the side effects of the BP drugs? Because I'm sure you've heard a lot of it, that people at a certain age are very reluctant of using these BP drugs for a lifetime. And my grandparents and everyone around us, whoever has this problem, they have this issue in their mind that abhi ye lifetime to nahi lungi, aaj do din chhod diya to kya ho gaya, ek din chhod diya to kya ho gaya. So what would you suggest in that case? What are the side effects?
Are you golgappe khati ho?
बहुत चाव से मैम.
Exactly. चाव से खाते हैं ना, जब when we go to that shop and we eat golgappas, do we ever ask the that भाई जी, is it safe? इसका कोई साइड इफेक्ट तो नहीं है? गोलगप्पे खाते हुए हम साइड इफेक्ट नहीं पूछते, पर हम दवाई खाते हुए साइड इफेक्ट पूछते हैं, जो दवाई हमारे को ठीक रखती है. See, by and large, speaking, if I have to tell you truly, even a tablet of paracetamol has a side effect. Okay? So please remember that. Medicines are by and large which are given for hypertension, they are very safe. Mm-hmm. Now safety cannot be 100% for anything. There is nothing like 100% in this world. Correct. You know, it is 1% chance is always there. We are sitting here, yadi chhat gir jaye sir ke upar, and you be are gone. Mm-hmm. Right? So such kind of eventualities always occur. By and large, the medicines for blood pressure are safe. They do not cause any damage or any major side effects, but you have to be careful in some kind of patients. Okay, now what happens is that in case you are at the age of 70 and above,
mm-hmm.
your renal function is reduced by 50%. वैसे सबका हो जाता है, not by drugs, सबका renal function is reduced with age, right? So if in a reduced renal function, you have a renal function which is deranged and you give some kind of drugs which are for blood pressure control, they may cause further damage of kidneys. So you have to be careful.
Okay.
Right? Now, there are some drugs which cause a decrease in the heart rate. Okay? So if you are already having a pre-existing slow heart rate, or there is some electrical conduction system disturbance in your heart, you give this blood pressure medicine to that patient, that will be further slowing of the heartbeat. It is not causing it is precipitating it.
Right.
You understand? So you have to be careful with some drugs, and you have to be very, very you have to use the drugs judiciously depending upon the age of the patient and the background of the patient, and what side effects it can cause. So, but you don't have to be scared. See, most of the time what happens is I see patients coming to me and saying, madam, 20 saal se ye medicine le rahe hain, to ye lete rahe kya? The answer is yes, you have to take medicine of blood pressure. Once started, it is for life. We never question ourselves ki bhook teen bari kyun lagti hai, teen bari khana kyun khana padta hai. तो एक अगर गोली खानी पड़ती है तो उसको क्यों क्वेश्चन करते हैं हम? लेकिन सेकेंडली दे कम एंड आस्क मी द क्वेश्चन, 20 इयर्स से खा रहे हैं गोली, इसका एफिकेसी तो नहीं कम हो गई होगी, कोई और दवाई ट्राई कर दीजिए. नाउ यू नो इफ यू आर स्टेबल ऑन वन ड्रग, यू आर डूइंग वेल, योर ब्लड प्रेशर इज वेल कंट्रोल्ड, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल उसकी एफिकेसी कम नहीं होती. देयर इज नथिंग कॉल्ड एज टॉलरेंस टू द ड्रग ऑफ ब्लड प्रेशर. यू नो ऐसा नहीं होता है कि वो टॉलरेंस डेवलप हो जाती है एंड इट डजंट वर्क. And secondly, if you are well settled on one drug and you're doing good, why should you try to change it? You have achieved what you wanted to achieve.
So वो शायद लोगों को ऐसा लगता है कि while we taking this drug since so many years, तो अब शायद अब लेना बंद करें, वो नौबत आ जाए तब तक ही लेना है. और अगर फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा है तो दूसरी दूसरी पे शिफ्ट हो जाए.
एब्सोल्युटली. और वो ये सोचते नहीं है कि अगर इसके ऊपर हमारे को कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा या पड़ रहा है तो क्या करें, वो छोड़ देते हैं. ब्लड प्रेशर ठीक था डॉक्टर साहब, इसलिए छोड़ दिया हमने. तो ब्लड प्रेशर तो दवाई से ठीक हुआ है ना, आपने क्यों छोड़ दिया? एनीवे, दैट इज द ह्यूमन नेचर एंड आई लाफ एट इट, यू नो, बिकॉज पेशेंट्स समटाइम्स डू थिंग्स सो इनोसेंटली दैट यू नो आउट ऑफ इग्नोरेंस एंड इनोसेंस.
So maybe because, ma'am, maybe because they have so many myths around them, कि उनको ये भी डर रहता है कि पूरी जिंदगी दवा लेने से कोई और प्रॉब्लम ना हो जाए और इससे किसी एक चीज से बचने के बजाय दूसरी चीज ना लग जाए. अब इतना वो मतलब बॉडी भी अफोर्ड नहीं कर सकती शायद इतनी बीमारियां.
So I know you are correct, there are many reasons for this, that's why I say they do it out of ignorance. So awareness is very important, you know, removing their ignorance. What you are doing now, you know, trying to create awareness through this show, this is important. It should reach to many people and they should know that nahi, medicine hai, agar stable ho to achhi baat hai, iska matlab body mein wo stable ho gayi hai and it is doing well to your body.
Right. So ma'am, for the COVID-19 and hypertension, what are the links and risks?
COVID-19 in itself is a big risk for everything, you know. It is a very tricky virus which has troubled us in a number of ways. So see, COVID-19 has caused a lot of stress, and I have seen blood pressure rising in patients because of the stress. So stress is both ways. Stress is of not getting COVID, preventing oneself from COVID. And secondly, it is from, if you've got COVID, then what will be the outcome?
Correct.
Right. And then you are inside the house from almost about a year, more than a year.
True.
And that has caused a lot of stress, depression, anxiety, and all these things, they cause blood pressure, all these things. So many patients are coming to me with overshooting blood pressures and overnight, having very high blood pressures. Some of them have had blood also. They have blood in the brain. They have had bleeds. They have had strokes. I have had three, four patients with that because of high blood pressure. So, they are scared to go to the hospital because most of the hospitals are COVID positive. So they don't want to go to the hospital. They delay their going to the hospital, which causes more problems. Rather than solve the problems. So it's a very tricky situation. And what I can say is that it's COVID-19. If it is not causing it itself, the side effects of COVID are killing, you know.
Correct.
That is the most stressful part. So my suggestion here would be, please don't unnecessarily stress yourself where you don't have to. Anxiety is not good for you. Don't go towards depression side at all. That is not there. If anything like this is happening, please seek help from your cardiologist, from a psychotherapist, talk to somebody. Vent out your feelings.
Right.
And you will be able to help yourself and your family with that.
Very well said, ma'am. Thank you so much, Dr. Vanita, for coming to our show, sharing your valuable time and your valuable insights with the knowledge that you have with our viewers today. I hope it helps them to the maximum extent. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure having you on the show. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.